people have been studying neurons for quite a bit of time, actually, and two main features that are really important. One is that the device should be small, so it doesn't cause very much damage, and the other one is that it should be biocompatible, so it doesn't damage tissues. So we're working to use polymers, which is a unique approach, and we're making polymer fibers that are really flexible, so when they're put in the brain, they don't cause a lot of scarring.
So the fabrication method that we use makes use of a process that is used commonly in the telecommunication industry, which is the thermal drawing process. In this process, we start with a large template of what we want to be the geometry of our neural probe. And then by heating it and applying controlled stress, we can reduce its dimensions in a great factor, up to 200 times. So this allows us to design a geometry in a scale that is easy for us to fabricate and then reduce its dimension to a useful scale.
So after we thermally draw the fiber, it looks like about this, and it's super flexible, but it's still a little bit too thick to be implanted, so we're going to selectively etch the outer layer or the cladding so we can make it smaller to be implanted. So we started off with a diameter similar to this one, which is about the diameter of a fishing wire, and then this piece here shows the transition from that thicker fishing wire to a diameter closer to the human hair, and then it's this thinner piece here that we're going to start using to connect to a board and prepare for implantation.
So one of the advantages of this method, this fabrication method, is that we can incorporate many different materials in the same process, and by combining different materials we can achieve different functionalities in our devices. So we can achieve not only recording electrodes, but also have ways in which we can guide light into the brain or also inject drugs. And in this work, we show for the first time that we can modulate the activity in the brain via the injection of drugs while we are stimulating neurons in the brain using light with a method called optogenetics. And through all this process in which we are stimulating and modulating the response of the neurons, we are recording this activity in the neurons. We hope that these devices that we have developed can be useful for other people to do further experiments in the brain. So people that are more interested in discovering how the brain works, we hope that these tools will be helpful for them in discovering these relationships in the brain.